Well, these humid days, these are the days fan motors go out, and I've got a fan motor out here, so I've got to change the fan motor, and so I'm going to discharge my capacitor. I got some screws here to take off the fan lid so we can gain access to the fan motor. My 6-in-1 screwdriver works good for this. It's got a nut driver on there. Pull all these screws out all the way around the unit. We already discharged our capacitor, and now's our fan capacitor. I'm going to discharge that too, just for safe measure. Okay, this is an old one, but we'll get rid of that now. We have to disconnect the fan wiring and such. You've got a black wire or a blue wire, and a yellow wire for the fan, and then two brown wires that go to the capacitor, depending on how your capacitor is wired. Slip these off here. I just kind of use my screwdriver underneath the terminal lead. Just slip it off here. There we go. Anytime you replace a fan motor, you always want to replace the capacitor at the same time. So we're going to do that too. Take this old one off here. Okay, we'll check that. Okay, now we can lift our lid out. Wiring feeds through. So I'll pull this down. And I'm going to put it on this service mat here. Now you always want to make sure you use these service mats, because that will protect your roof material, especially if you have a built-up roof like I do. So anyway, pull the lid off and set it on the service mat. And I'll start with the worst part first, which is getting the fan blades off. So you can probably see just how rusted the post is for the fan. What we've got is some emery cloth. It's a waterproof type sandpaper. And what we're going to do is sand the post of the fan so that we can remove the blades. Removing the fan blades, what we're going to do is we are going to sand the post really good with our emery cloth here. Kind of like we're sanding shoes. You can see it starting to come off there. The oxide. Thank you. some of these can be pretty tough. Sometimes you get lucky, sometimes not so much. Anyway, it's really humid out here today, Palm Springs. Probably about 100 degrees right now, but it's really sticky humid. California, but it kind of feels like Palm Springs, Florida, even though it's Palm Springs, California. There's a little bit of a breeze, and it just seems like on these humid days when there's high pressure, this is when fan motors tend to go down. Anyway, next what we're going to do is loosen these bolts up. Believe it or not, what I found works best is slip these off. It's actually just cold water. We're gonna take a little cold water here, a little for the fan, a little for me. Then take my channel locks and just underneath the fan, hold it and wiggle it a little bit, and then pull the fan blades up and off. And watch your fingers with your blades when you do this. Believe me, it's a little easier said than done. But sometimes you just get lucky. This is the hardest, trickiest part, but you get past this, you're good. My little bigger channel locks here. Yeah, you want to take care not to bend the fan blades. Pretty rough, but we did. Next, we want to move our old fan motor. Doing our bolts here. As you can see, this entire unit got a pretty good crack in the lid. It's still alive. I'd come back later and put some washers over these. I don't have any with me now, so I can do that on a follow-up. Just keep it live longer. That way the crack won't matter so much. You don't have a nice huge washer that can just go over that spot. Sometimes the new motors don't come with the bolts, so you always want to bring your own bolts. idiot. This is the only one of these I have to do today. Okay, now we want to feed our wire up here. Earlier, a lot of times the units don't come with their own bolt. I went ahead and put them inside the new capacitor lid. There's my bolts there. Brought a couple extras just in case. Now back to mounting the motor. Just gonna pass it through our new holes. Washers I was telling you about. A couple bolts on here before I get too far. Thank you. gonna get some big washers that go over this to squish this down. That way our fan doesn't wind up falling into the unit. Maybe I should just go do that now and get some of those washers that we're telling you about. I'd rather get them AC faster, but you gotta do this right.
There we go. I'll be back.
Okay, so I went back and got some washers just to make this better. This way things aren't just gonna fall apart on us here. Get in there. It's to be part of the air conditioning. All right. I'll just put one on each spot just to make things equal. Try to keep this thing alive. two ends of these are squared. That's where we're going to line up our bolts here. Squared ends. Okay. We want to get it as close as we can, but without touching here. Get a full rotation. Obviously not hitting these bolts. And we're good right here. We do want it up as far as we can. Without hitting the bolts or without hitting the baffle. So we can get good as well. Good on here. Across the condenser coils. So finger tighten those and then down tighten. Channel locks here. Snag. Don't want them coming off. Okay. Now we're ready to put our lid back on. We're going to have to feed the wires through the face here. Set it in place so the baffle's in the center, and then we're gonna lift it up, feed our wires through here. So next we'll kind of pull the conduit through here. And then now it's a matter of seating our lid on properly. And actually got pretty lucky on this one. Looks like it's pretty much falling into place except on this side here. And I just kind of use my screwdriver underneath and lift this up into place. There might be a little more stuff here. There we go. And I just kind of turn it so that that moves it into the right spot. Okay. Come back around to this side. We have to lift this a little bit. There we go. Beautiful. Now I can put the mounting screws back in. And this is where the 6-in-1 screwdriver really comes in handy. Just being able to switch between the flat blade and the nut driver. It's out really well. And also that it's got the insulated handle. Very nice. Okay, now we're going to be hooking up our new start capacitor for the fan. Oh, look how hot it is out here from my glove. Oh man. Anyway, it's good. We've discharged the capacitor and all that good stuff. Okay, we're going to go black to black, and then the white lead will go. Sometimes it's to a yellow, sometimes to a blue. Depends on whoever wired this up here. See the sweat is pouring out of my gloves here. All right, now we're ready to fire it up. Okay. Disconnect over here. Make sure my fan's rotating the right way. It is. just switch those two around, make it work that way. All right, nice day out there. Nice swampy day.